Okay, we'll start inshallah. Starting Surah Al-Baqarah from Al-Quran. We'll be starting from ayah number 151 onwards inshallah. Let's see how much we cover. Okay. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Alhamdulillahi allazi nahmaduhu wa nusalli ala rasulihil kareem. Amma ba'd fa'audhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. ربي اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي ربي زدنا علما اللهم فقهنا في الدين اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا وعلمنا ما ينفعنا وزدنا علما. These are the root words. You can take the snapshots and then you know mark on your juice on your para. Inshallah it will be great helpful for you. So we are starting Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah number 151, inshallah. What translation first? Kama, just as like, arsalna, arsal sent, arsalna, we sent, fikum, in among you all, fi, in among kum, you, rasulan, a rasul, a messenger, minkum, from you all, min from kum you, yatlu he reads, recites, alaykum upon you, Allah upon kum you, he recites upon you all. What he recites? Ayatina, our ayah verses, ayati, ayah verses, na our. Na means our. Wa yuzakkikum, wa and yuzakkikum, he completely purifies you all. Kum means you all. Wa and yuallimukum, he teaches you all. Again, kum means you all. Al kitaba, the kitab, the writ, the book. Wa and al hikmata, the hikmah, the wisdom. Wa and yuallimukum, he teaches you all. Kum means you all. Ma, whatever. Lam, did not. Takunu, you all are. Ta'alamun, you all know. Now we'll see the running translation of ayah 151. Kama, similarly. Okay, similarly. Arsalna fikum. To complete my blessings on you, within bracket, to complete my blessings on you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says here that similarly, what Allah did similarly? To complete my blessings on you, arsalna, we have sent, fikum, among you, rasulan, a messenger. Who is the messenger? Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Minkum, of your own. He's among from us, okay? Minkum of your own. Now, what the Rasul, the messenger does? Yatlu, reciting alaykum to you. Prophet Sassam, number one. Now, start counting. What Prophet Sassam does? Allah says, this is the mansab of Prophet Sassam. There are many duties of Prophet Sassam, among which this is the duty, this is the mission of Prophet Sassam. Number one, Yatlu. Alaykum, reciting to you. What he recites? Ayatina, our verses. Our verses, meaning the Quran, okay? Wa yuzakkikum, number two. And purifying you. Purifying you. Number three, wa yuallimukumul kitab, and teaching you the book. That is the Quran. Number three, wal hikmah, and the hikmah. What is hikmah? That is Sunnah, Islamic laws, and fiqh, jurisprudence. Okay, and then number one was what? Ayatina. Number two, Vayuzakkikum. Number three, Vayuallimukum al-kitab. Number four, al-hikmah. So the four things, Prophet Sassam, this ayah says, Allah tells us that he teaches. Vayuallamukum, and teaching you what? Ma lam takunu ta'lamun, that which you did not know. Okay, so we'll see number one. First of all, we see kama, similarly or just as. What does tama means? Similarly or just as, meaning that just as Allah sent the messenger to guide you. In the previous ayah we read, similarly Qibla was ordained for your guidance, right? And then just as, similarly, meaning just as messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam was a blessing, Qibla was also a blessing. Messenger is also a blessing and Qibla facing towards Kaaba is also a blessing. Just as, similarly, just as messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam has been sent to complete the deen, Qibla was ordained to complete the deen. Okay, now you see kama arsalna feekum rasulam minkum yatlu alaykum ayatina. Okay, similarly, to complete my blessings on you, we have sent among your messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam of your own, reciting to you our verses. Okay, yatlu alaykum ayatina, doing tilawa. Okay, why tilawa is mentioned first? Because tilawa is first thing to be done. Until, and you see, everybody knows, when a child is started, you know, talking, 6 years, 5 years, 7 years of age, depending on, you know, the child, how smart, you know, how, you know, fast he or she is in learning. So first thing, what parents do, the Muslim parents, they just start, you know, teaching them alif ba ta sa, and then after that the alphabets, then, you know, parents start teaching him what, him or her Quran. Okay, and first they endeavor, they try hard that the child should learn the reading of the Quran, the tilawa of the Quran. Once you know the reading, how the Quran is recited, how the tilawa is, then you can do root words, word to word translation and tafsir and running translation and everything, which is why tilawa is mentioned first. Yatlu alaykum ayatina, because tilawa is the first thing to be done. Okay, when you know the tilawa, when you can read the Arabic of Quran, then, you know, it's very easy for you to learn the meaning and everything. Okay, so now we see yatlu alaykum ayatina, then wayuzakkikum. Okay, after reciting to you our verses, the Quran, wayuzakkikum, purifying you. So how did Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam purify the people? By telling them what is right and wrong, so that people do what is right and leave that which is wrong. Okay, wayuzakkikum, meaning number one, reciting you the verses, number two, wayuzakkikum, purifying you. So he purifies people by telling them what is right and wrong, so that people do what is right and leave that which is wrong, and then cleans themselves. Wayuzakkikum, purify them, then cleans themselves. How he cleans them? By removing shirk and false practices. You know, when people left Islam, they were following the deen of Ibrahim before Prophet ﷺ, and when at the time of Prophet ﷺ also. But you know, they have mixed the, they were doing shirk. There were 360 idols in Khana Kaaba, in Baitullah, in the house of Allah, and they were practicing shirk. You know, they were associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and there were many false practices which had no, you know, which was not proved from deen, which was no deen. You know, all were false practices. So Prophet Sallam taught them and taught us what, which is right and wrong, so that people do what is right and leave that which is wrong, and cleans themselves by removing shirk and false practices. Okay, so okay. Now, what else did Prophet Sallam teach us? Wayuallimukumul kitab. After wayuzakkikum, wayuallimukumul kitab. He taught us the book of Allah and wal hikmah, wisdom. Through his, how he taught us the book and how he taught us wisdom? Through his words and actions. Whatever was revealed in Quran, whatever is revealed in Quran, he did everything practically. So through his words and actions, he taught us al-hikmah, the wisdom, those things which we had no idea about. وَيُعَلِّمُكُمْ مَا لَمْ تَكُونُوا تَعْلَمُونَ. And what he taught us, and teaching you that which you did not know. So those things which we had no idea about, that also he taught us through Quran. So there are many things which we'll never know, which we will never know unless we study the Deen. Okay. And you are practicing, you are experiencing. Every week you join here, we learn ayahs, verses of Quran, and we do the tafsir also, by tafsir, by running translation. We are learning many things, and you have proved, you have experienced that the things which we never knew, that also we learn through Quran, right? So there are many things which we will never know unless we study the Deen. So gaining knowledge is very important to live. Gaining the knowledge of the world, the worldly knowledge, and also especially the revealed knowledge, the knowledge from the Quran, the knowledge from the Wahi, which is sent to Prophet Sallam. So gaining knowledge is very important to live. Okay. So let's start the tafsir. Okay. So Muhammad Sallam's prophecy is a great bounty from Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Allah says the ayah. We have done the word-to-word translation. We have done the running translation. And I explained to you also. So Allah reminds his believing servants with what he has endowed them with by sending Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as a messenger to them, reciting to them Allah's clear ayat and purifying and cleansing them from the worst types of behavior and ills of the souls and the acts of jahiliya. What are the acts of jahiliya? Pre-Islamic era, before Prophet Sallam was revealed Quran and he was appointed prophet. That period is called pre-Islamic era, where what they were they were worse type. Their behavior was worse, and the souls was ills, and the acts of jahiliya were there. That is pre-Islamic era. The messenger also takes them away from the darkness of disbelief to the light of faith. When you disbelieve, you are in darkness. You don't know what is wrong, what is right, what is, false acts. So messenger also, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, also takes them away from the darkness of disbelief to the light of faith and teaches them the book, that is the Quran, and the hikmah. And what is hikmah? That is the wisdom, which is his sunnah. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sunnah is called hikmah also, wisdom also. And this Quran is telling us that hikmah. He also teaches them what they not know. We have learned all this in this ayah now. So during the time of Jahiliya, they used to utter foolish statements. Later on, and with the blessings of the Prophet's message and the goodness of his prophecy, they were elevated to the status of the awliya. And who are the awliya? Loyal friends of Allah and the rank of the scholars. Hence, they acquired the deepest knowledge among the people, the most pious hearts and the most truthful tongues. And this was all through the teachings of Prophet Sallam, through the book of Allah, Quran, how they become awliya, because and by learning and leaving the evil practices, they raised to the rank of the scholars, and acquiring the deepest knowledge of Quran, and their heart became pious, and their tongue also were truthful, because they learned through the ayahs that if we tell lie, it is a sin. If we backbite, it is a sin. If our language is foul or evil deeds, ultimately they are going to take us to the hellfire, and Allah will punish us. So they were changed to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah said in chapter number 3, 164, indeed Allah conferred a great favor on the believers when he sent among them a messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from among themselves, reciting unto them his verses, the Quran, and purifying them from sins. And these four things we learn in the ayah also. Yatlu alayhim ayati wa yuzakkihim wa yuallimhumul kitaba wal hikmah. This is our ayah, and this is the ayah in reference to this. Allah also criticized those who did not give this bounty its due consideration, because this is the bounty. This is the Quran is the favor. Prophet Sallam is a bounty. Quran is a bounty. Quran is a favor. Prophet Sallam is a favor. And it's a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, Allah also criticized those who did not give this bounty its due consideration. So we should give due consideration to Quran and the teachings of Prophet Sallam. So Allah said, Have you not seen those who have changed the favors of Allah into disbelief by denying Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and his message of Islam and cause their people to dwell in the house of destruction? So those who disbelieve, those who deny Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, those who deny the message of Islam, which is from the book of Allah, what will happen? They will dwell in the house of destruction. So Ibn Abbas, he's the cousin of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So he narrates, Allah's favors means Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Here the favor means what? Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. It's a blessing of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, because Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam taught from Quran, he taught us so many things. Therefore, Allah has commanded the believers to affirm this favor and to appreciate it by thanking and remembering him. So what should the believers should do? What should Allah has commanded us? That we should affirm this favor and we should appreciate it by thanking and remembering him. So how we can thank him? We should remember Allah and we should be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Otherwise, we would have been in pitch darkness and we would have done sins and, you know, we would have displeased Allah. And then, you know, the punishment would have been there. Okay. So now we see from Ayah 151, just as Allah sent the messenger to guide you, similarly, Qibla was ordained for your guidance. Just as, because Allah says, Kama arsalna, just as messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam was a blessing, Qibla was also a blessing, his favor. Just as messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam has been sent to complete the deen, Qibla was ordained to complete the deen. Okay, now we face, what is our Qibla direction? Facing Khana Kaaba, which is in Makkah. And now the first word was what? See the ayah. I'll show you the ayah again. Kama arsalna feekum rasulna minkum yatlu alaykum ayatina. Okay, first was what? Ayat, tilawa. Vayuzakkikum. Second word was what? That this reciting to your verses the Quran and purifying you. Vayuzakkikum, and purifying you. Then the third thing, vayuallimukumul kitab, and teaching you the book, the Quran. The fourth thing was wal hikma, and the hikmah. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam teaches all these things. And what is hikmah? That is the sunnah of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Islamic laws and fiqh and jurisprudence. وَيُعَلِّمُكُمْ مَا لَمْ تَكُونُوا تَعْلَمُونَ, and teaching you that which you did not know. Okay, so let's see, let's conclude. So this ayah, so why tilawa is mentioned first? Because tilawa is first thing to be done. Until and unless you know how to recite Quran, the Arabic of the Quran, how to do tilawa, you cannot, you know, understand further. Once you know the tilawa, once you are, you know, familiar with the Arabic words, and you can recite the Quran, then only you can learn word to word translation, the meanings, the root words, you know, the tafsir, all the things. So how did Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam purify the people? By telling them what is right and wrong, so that people do what is right and leave that which is wrong, and cleanse themselves. Cleaning from what? By removing shirk and fault practices which were prevailing at that time and which prevails now also. Now also. What else did Prophet taught? The book of Allah, wisdom through his words and actions, which is called hikmah. Allah told hikmah in the ayah. So wisdom, those things which we had no idea about also, he taught that also. Because Allah said, he taught which you never knew. So there are many things which we will never know unless we study the deen, which is why we gather here and we study the deen to know what Allah has taught us. Because the whole life we have learned many subjects in school, colleges, science, geography, history, psychology, and I don't know what. And many branches of sciences and math and algebra and I don't know, trigonometry, etc. But this is only one book. There are many books we learn in this dunya, but you know, people give deaf ear to this book, which is only one book. So we should gain knowledge is very important to live. Not the worldly knowledge also, going to school, colleges also, to improve our life, and especially the revealed knowledge, the wahi, the Quran, which is revealed to Prophet Sallam. Okay, okay. Now let's do ayah number 152, inshallah. Word-to-word translation, Suratul Baqarah, ayah 152. Fadhkuruni, so, Azkuru, remember, mention. You all remember, mention, and the ya afternoon, ni ya. Ya means me. First kuruni, so you all remember, you all mention me. Azkurkum, I shall mention, remember you all. Va and Vashkuru, you all thank, you all be grateful, li to for me. Wa and la do not. Takfuruni, you all be ungrateful, deny, disbelieve me. See the word faskuruni. Ya after the word, after the verb means me. But takfuruni, you will say there is no ya. See takfuruni, there is no ya. But still your meaning is you all be ungrateful, deny, disbelieve me. Now my question is, you see noon, under the noon there is a kasra, right? There is zair, there is kasra, and we pronounce as ya. Takfuruni means me. So Tamina, can you explain? There is no ya, but still we say me in the meaning, in the word-to-word translation. Why me?
Gurjan, ashkuruli, washkuruli.
Yeah, takfuruni. See the word takfuruni.
There is no. Oh yeah. Noon ya zemi.
Then still we say me.
Yeah, yeah. Because why? We this is ya mutakallim is absent here, but we have the same NY. Sorry, fashkuru ni me hai na ya mutakallim, washkuru li me hai bhi. All about Allah. He's talking about himself.
Yeah, but you know when there's a kasra, you pronounce as ya. See, yeah. Takfuru ni. Because yeah. You're pronouncing ya, so ya is hazaf ya.
Yeah, there is a ya here, but we cannot see. It's like absent. Yeah,
yeah,
like absent, but there is a
y. Yeah. You caught it. Ya is there. Ya is hazaf. It's present, but we can't see. But we pronounce takfuruni. So ya means me, right? I hope it's clear to everybody. In the end also, if it's not clear, we'll make it clear, okay? Tamina will explain us, inshallah. Sister Tamina, okay. So now running translation. I love this ayah. This is a, you know, honor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us. By the explanation, we'll come to know. First, kuruni. So now in the last verses, we learned about the favors upon us. Favors upon us, favor of Quran, favor of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that we have come out of pitch darkness. We come to know what is right, what is wrong. Allah told us about the blessings, his favors. First of all, you know, we are born in Muslim families. This is the, you know, greatest favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on us. Greatest blessings, you know. And then Allah, you know, reminded us all the favors in the shape of Quran, in the shape of Prophet Sallam, in the time of, say, shape of teaching of Prophet Sallam via Quran, through the Quran. So now Allah says, so what you do? So somebody give you a gift, what you say? Thank you, jazakallah khair, right? We are grateful to that person, you know, to parents, to siblings, to friends, to anybody. So same thing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, since I've given you, I've favored you a lot, my blessings are countless, so what you do, first kuruni, therefore remember me. Okay, so how remember me? By praying, by glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what will happen? This is a great honor for us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says us in this ayah 152. I love this ayah like anything. Therefore, faskuruni, therefore remember me. How? By praying and glorifying. Okay? Then what will happen? If you remember me, if you pray me, if you glorify, if you are thankful, if you are grateful, the favors which I have bestowed upon you, countless favor, وَإِن تَعُدُّ نِعْمَتِي لَا تَحْصُوهَا, if you start counting my name, my blessings, my favors, you will not be able to count. They are countless. So what Allah says, if you remember me, أَذْكُرْكُمْ, I will remember you. It's a great honor for us. You remember me? I will remember you. You know, we remember our friends, you know, our relatives, but some they forget. We keep on messaging them, though we don't get the answer the whole day or 2 days WhatsApp answer. We keep on calling them. Sometimes, you know, they are so forgetful, they are not mindful, and you know, they don't reply. But what Allah says, you remember me by praying, by glorifying, I will remember you. It's a great honor for us. And then Allah says, for my favors, for my blessings, washkuru li wa an. Washkuruli, be grateful to me. For why to be grateful for to me? For my countless favors on you, for my countless blessings on you. And the previous ayahs, we are learning all the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, changing of Qibla, and you know, Prophet and Quran and Hikmah. We are getting wisdom also, Hikmah also. I would love to know, you know, after the dust, a few points about Hikmah, you know. What hikmah we get from the Sunnah of Prophet is actually the hikmah is the wisdom, and that is that we learn via Sunnah to the Sunnah of Prophet. Okay, so for my countless favors on you, be grateful to me. Washkuru li, do shukar. Okay, and what to do? What other thing Allah says? Wala takfuruni, and never be ungrateful to me. So never be ungrateful. Okay. Now we learn through the, you know, tafsir. So yeah. Okay. This is ayah 52. Remember me, first kuruni, remember me. How? By obeying me. Then what will happen? First kuruni, by obeying me, askurkum, I will remember you. How Allah will remember us? By forgiving you. You see the reward? First kuruni, remember me. How? By obeying me, askurkum, by obeying me, by praying me, by glorifying me, especially by obeying me. When you obey, automatically you pray and glorify, right? When you obey. So remember me by obeying me, and I will askurkum, and I will remember you by forgiving you. So Allah will forgive. When you offer one prayer, Fajr prayer, and then you offer the Zohar prayer, from one prayer to the second prayer, you know, small sins, you know, asghar sins are forgiven. Everybody knows that. You know, after one salah to other salah, one prayer to other prayer, what happened? One namaz to other namaz, your, you know, saghira sins, small sins are forgiven, right? Okay. So Ibn Abbas tells about this ayah, I am as my servant, think as I'm. This is the hadith from Ibn Abbas, the narrator is Ibn Abbas, the cousin of Prophet Sallam. I am as my servant thinks I am. Allah says, when he mentions me in his heart, I mention him in my heart. When he mentions me in a gathering, I mention him in a better gathering of Malaul Ala. What is Malaul Ala? Gathering of angels. See, now we are mentioning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the gathering. We all are gathered here. Okay. So now we are mentioning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here in the gathering. So Allah says, I will mention my servants in a better gathering. And what is the, which is the better gathering than dunya? The better gathering of Malaul Ala in the gathering of angels. Allah feel pride in the gathering of angels. And you know, everybody knows that there are many, many angels. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them different variety of duties. Some angels, their duty is that they go to cities, to place to places, to the corners of the cities, and you know, everywhere they go, and they search the place where people are gathered, the servant of Allah's are gathered, whether male or female, and they do zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where they pray and glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they find these halakas, these gathering, and then, you know, Allah knows everything. But still Allah, you know, ask them why my servants are gathered, what they are doing, what they are asking. So the angel says have gathered, they are, you know, remembering you, they are glorifying you. So Prophet, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, be witness. This gathering is so special. I like this gathering so much that you be witness that I have forgiven them. I have forgiven their sins. Then the angel says, oh, such and such person, such and such guy, or such and such lady, or such and such man or woman, his or her intention was not, you know, to go to this gathering. He or she just went to meet somebody. And it happens when you know that in your vicinity, some halaka, some gathering is going on, and you know, you can't find some of your friend or somebody, and you know that somebody goes there. So you think, you know, you are mindful, you say, oh, let's go and meet her there. And you know, I will meet her also, and I will listen Allah's kalam also, kalam Allah also, and you know, this zikr and this dars also. So Allah says, this gathering is so, you know, valuable, so I value so much, so special, that forgive that man or that woman also, no matter he or she has been there to meet her or his relative or friend. Okay, so I like this hadith also, and this is hadith Qudsi. Hadith Qudsi means there are no narrators. This is direct from Allah Subhanahu wa Taala to Prophet Sallam. So let's see the okay. Now this is what a great honor that Allah mentions a person. Faskuruni askurkum. I will, you remember me, I will remember you. So it's a great honor that Allah mentions a person, and he feels pride in the gathering of Malaul Ala, in the gathering of angels, that see, my servants have gathered, and they are, you know, glorifying me, and you know, praying for me, asking, you know, Jannah from me, and they are, you know, seeking refuge from hellfire, and they are glorifying me. So what a great honor that Allah mentions a person. So we should be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and do not deny his favors, his blessings, his gifts. Do not be ungrateful to him by disobeying him. So obey Allah's every command, as that shows shukr as well. You know, obeying command means what? We are showing, we are grateful. We are showing shukr also. So think about his blessings and do his zikrs all the time. Always keep your tongue moist with the zikr, with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Any remembrance, you know, all the shorter one, the bigger one, the greater one. La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu minaz zalimin. Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi subhanallahi lazim. Third kalma, fourth kalma, subhanallahi walhamdulillahi wa la ilaha illallahu allahu akbar la hawla la quwwata illa billah lazim. Anything or any ayah, you're doing word to word translations also, and you know, or the short, you know, surahs also. Surat al-Falaq, Nas, you know all the things. Almost last para, everybody knows the, you know, the shortest surahs, we all know, which we, you know, do tilawa in our obligatory prayers also, right? Okay, let's see the tafsir of this. First kuruni askurkum, vash kuruli wala takfuruni. So we have done this ayah also, wadu for translation also. So Mujahid said that Allah's statement, Kama arsalna fikum rasulum minku. Similarly, to complete my favor on you, we have sent among you a messenger, Muhammad, of your own. Means, therefore, remember me in gratitude to my favor. And Hasan al-Basri commented about all Allah's statement. These are all commentators, the Mufassirin. Hasan Basri and, you know, Mujahid, they all are the Mufassirin, commentators. First kuruni askurkum, therefore remember me, I will remember you. Remember me regarding what I have commanded you, and I will remember you regarding that, regarding what I have compelled myself to do for your benefit. What is our benefit? That is his rewards and forgiveness. So I think it's clear to you. Askurkum means what as first kuruni, you remember me, I will remember you. So remember me means regarding that what I have commanded you. We have to obey what Allah has commanded us. Then Allah says, I will remember you, what I have compelled myself to do for you, for your benefit. Allah has compelled himself to do for our benefit. And what is that? His rewards and forgiveness. And when it comes, the rewards and forgiveness comes when we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is an authentic hadith in this context that Allah the Exalted said, whoever mentions me to himself then I will mention him to myself, and whoever mentions me in a gathering, I will mention him in a better gathering, that is Malaul Ala, in the gathering of angels. Imam Ahmad reported that Anas radiallahu anhu narrated that Allah's messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allah the exalted said, O son of Adam, if you mention me to yourself, I will mention you to myself. So if there is not a gathering, you mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to yourself also, okay? It's not as necessary that always every time there is a gathering and you mention. No, you can, you know, always you mention yourself also. Do the zikr yourself also, okay? Keep your tongue moist with the zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you know, all the du'as of all the times, while waking up, whilst going to sleep, while going to the bathroom, while you know, going into the elevator, while ascending and descending, while you are ascending, you should say Allahu Akbar. While you are descending the staircases, you should say Subhanallah. In the elevator also, ascending and descending. The du'as of all the times is also a dhikr and remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So never forget when leave the house, okay? While sitting in the car. And I remember Raisa and Fatma and Hiba, you have grown up now, still you are a daughters and child for me. You used to come to my house and we used to, you know, memorize all the du'as after our Quran classes, you know. MashaAllah, everybody knows. You have learned from the masajid also, from other places also, and we used to do revise the dua in my house also. Everybody remember, I know that. Okay, so golden memories of old times. Okay, mashallah, now you are all are, you know, college going students. Hiba is still not a college going student, but she's in high school. Okay, there is a Imam Ahmad reported that Anas radiallahu anhu narrated that Allah's messenger said, Allah the exalted said, O son of Adam, if you mention me to yourself, I will mention you to myself. If you mention me in a gathering, I will mention you in a gathering of the angels, or said in a better gathering. Of course, the gathering of angels, the gathering of Malaul Ala is better than the gathering of this world. There is no comparison, okay? Of this world and the gathering of, you know, Malaul Ala on the seven heavens. If you draw closer to me by a hand span, I will draw closer to you by a four arms length. If you draw closer to me by a four arms length, I will draw closer to you by an arm's length. If you come to me walking, I will come to you running. See, the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is an honor. And you know, there's another riwayah, remember? There's a riwayah, the gist, I'm just telling the gist. I will be your eyes, I will be your hand. Allah says, I will be your foot. So it's also a blessing, okay? Its chain is sahih. It was recorded by Al-Bukhari, and Bukhari is the most authentic hadith book everybody knows after the Quran. So Allah said, Washkuru li wala takfuruni. After saying Allah says, and be grateful to me for my countless favors on you, and never be ungrateful to me. Everybody knows, it's a fact. If if you start counting my nema, my blessings, my favors, you will not be able to count it. So never be ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In this ayah, Allah commands that he be thanked and appreciated, and promises even more rewards for thanking him. Washkuru li wala takfuruni. So Allah promises that if you obey my commands, if you are thankful, and you so Allah appreciate that even more rewards, Allah will give more rewards for thanking him. Allah said in another ayah, there's another ayah with reference to our ayah, and remember when your Lord proclaimed, if you give thanks by accepting faith and worshipping none but Allah, meaning not associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not doing shirk, I will give you more of my blessings. But if you are thankless, that is disbelievers, verily my punishment is indeed severe. Okay, there's another hadith. Abu Raja and Al-Utardi said, Imran bin Hussein came by us once wearing a nice silken garment. This is the name of a companion. he came, his name is Imran bin Hasan, and he came to them, and he was wearing a nice silken garment that we never saw him wear before or afterwards. He said, Allah's messenger said that those whom Allah has favored with a bounty, then Allah likes to see the effect of his bounty on his creation. He said, Ala Abdihi, on his servant, according to Ru, one of the narrators of the Hadith. So here actually what is said, that that man came in a silken dress, right? Nobody had seen him before in this, you know, garment, in nice silken garment. So what he said, this, you know, good dress reminded him of a Hadith of Prophet Sallam, that those whom Allah has favored with a bounty, that Allah likes to see the effect of his bounty on his creation. You must have seen, you know, I would explain you, you know, by an example. You must have seen many of the people, your relatives or, you know, your friend, they have got good business, they are earning more, and still, you know, they don't wear good clothes, good shoes, good, they don't carry good, you know, bags, you know. So this is what, you know, Prophet Sallam says, that if you are privileged, if you have, you know, you are the privileged one, you have got all the facilities Allah has given you, Allah has favored you, you have got more money, more clothes, more things, so what you do, you should wear that. You should show that Allah has bestowed you with the blessings. But we see many people, you know, they don't like to, you know, show that the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You won't find them. And there's a riwayah, the gist of the hadith I'm telling you. A man came to the gathering of Prophet Sallam, and, you know, hairs were not combed properly. His clothes were not good. So when he left, Prophet Sallam said, Prophet Sallam asked the companions about that man, that is he not a privileged one? He hasn't got, you know, the facilities of life, meaning money or good clothes. They said, yes, Allah has favored him. So Prophet Sam said that when Allah favored you with a bounty, then Allah likes to see the effect of his bounty on his creation. If you have good clothes, the effect should be shown on your, you know, in your life. You must be wearing good clothes. You must be, you know, using good things which Allah has given you. It shouldn't be like that, you know, that showing that I am poor, you know, your clothes are not good, things you are using is not good. So the effect should be seen on your, the bounty which has Allah given you on yourself, okay? This is what's said here. So we'll see, we'll conclude. Remember me by obeying me, and I will remember you by forgiving you. So now you know the ayah. If you remember Allah, how? By obeying him, by glorifying him, you know. So what will happen? Obeying the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah says, I will remember you. How Allah will remember you? By forgiving you. Okay. So Ibn Abbas said that I am as my servant thinks I am. So what? The way you think about Allah. So Allah says, I am as my servant thinks I am. When he mentions me in his heart, when you are alone, you mention in your heart, I mention him in my heart. When he mentions me in a gathering, I mention him in a better gathering. And this is Hadith Qudsi. So what a great honor that Allah mentions a person. Okay, when you remember Allah mentions you. Be grateful to Allah and do not deny his favors. Do not be ungrateful to him by disobeying him. Obey Allah's every command, as that shows shukr as well. Think about his blessings and do his zikr all the time. So go home. So you are home. When the class ends, think about his blessings. And always think about his blessings. When you think about his blessings, what happens? You will be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And those who are not grateful to the people, they are not grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also. So be grateful to your parents also, to your siblings also, to your elders also, okay? And always be grateful to your parents. They have done a lot and they do a lot for you. Their sacrifices are immense. They sacrifice a lot for their children. Okay. Even they will starve. If the food is less, they'll fill your tummy. They will starve, they won't eat. You know? So be thankful to your parents also. Those who are not thankful to people, they are not thankful. They are not grateful to the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also. So gratitude brings beauty in your life. See what happens? Gratitude. If you are thankful, the gratitude brings beauty in your life. Your life will become beautiful, inshallah. First a lesson for me. Okay. Now 153. After 153, inshallah, we'll finish because time will be over then. Ya ayyuha. What translation? Ayah 153. Ya ayyuha. O you. Allazina, those who. Amanu, they believe. Amanus ta'inu. You all seek help. Wow, alif shows the plural. You all, right? See, the word is ta'inu. Wow, alif shows plural. You all seek help. Bis sabri, be with. As sabr, the fortitude, the patience. Wa and as salah, as salati, the salah, the prayer. Inna, indeed. Allaha, Allah. Ma'a, is with. As sabreen, those who endured with sabr, those who endure with fortitude, those who endure with patience. Very beautiful ayah. Okay. Ya ayyuhal lazina, O you who believe. O you who believe. Okay. Allah is telling to whom? To the believers. Okay. What to do? Amanu. Allah says, O you believe. Amanu. O you who believe. Ya ayyuhal lazina amanu. What to do? Istainu. Seek help. How? Bis sabr. In patience. Seek help. In patience, wasala and asala with the prayer. So how to seek help? With patience and with salah, with the obligatory prayers. Inna allaha, truly Allah is ma'as sabreen, with as-sabreen, with the patient one. Allah is telling us that those who you have believed, though the believers, what to do? Istainu bisabris with salah. Istainu bisabr wa salah, seek help in patience and as salah, the prayer. Truly inna allaha ma sabreen, truly Allah is with as sabreen. Who are as sabreen? Those who do sabr. Those who do sabr are as sabreen. So sabr and salah. See, here are two words. Ya ayyuhallazina amanu istainu bisabr wa salah. See the word bisabr wa salah. So sabr and salah are very important for iman. See how we come to know is important with iman, because Allah says, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, O people, those who have iman, O people, those who have believed. So sabr and salah, these two things are very important for the believers, for very important for our iman. It increases our iman. So when is sabr done? See, bis sabr. When is sabr done? Sabr is done on a difficult situation, on good deeds also, that it might be challenging for you. But you keep on doing it, because difficult situation is always challenging for you. So you should keep it on doing it. Do sabr. When there calamities come, some hardships come, some difficult situation arises, so what to do? Do sabr. Okay? Because there is a challenge. So stay firm doing sabr on staying away from sins. What happens? Sometimes some calamities fall, some difficult situations come, some hardships, so people, they do sins also. They indulge themselves, involve themselves in sins also. So no matter how the, situation is, how difficult, one should stay away from sins. Okay, one should do sabr. When we do sabr, we stay away from sins. Sabr help us also in staying away from sins. So sabr, in other words, is self-control. What is sabr? Sabr is self-control. It does not mean being passive, not caring, but having self-control. So it's a self-control, right? So Allah being with them means, see, Allah says, istainu bisabr wa salah, seek help in patience and as-salah, the prayer. So inna allaha ma sabreen, to those who do sabr, and those who take the help of seek help in patience and with salah. So what Allah do? Inna Allah ma'as sabreen. Truly Allah is with as sabreen. Those who do sabr, they are called as sabreen, the patient ones. So Allah is with them. It means Allah is with them in the general sense that Allah is with them, giving them blessings. When do you do sabr? Allah is with you. How? He will give you blessings in the general sense. And in the specific sense, that Allah provides some people especially. Some, you know, especially Allah provide for them. And you must have noticed when you are in difficulty, it seems, oh, this difficulty is not going to go. Some people, you know, get so much sick that, you know, people say, now he or she will die. And the person himself says, oh, I don't find courage. I'm, you know, I'm suffering a lot. One day I will die. But, you know, when that person is patience and, you know, seek help with patience and with prayer, with salah, so special help come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah being with them, in Allah ma sabreen, truly Allah is with a sabreen, the patient. So Allah being with them means in the general sense that Allah is with them, giving them blessings. And in the specific sense that Allah provides some people specially. Okay, so the person who is patient is not alone. When you are patient, you are, you know, doing sabr on the calamities and hardships, and you, if you are tested, so the person who is patient is not alone. He is not suffering in silence. Allah's help is with them, because Allah himself telling, in Allah ma sabreen, truly Allah is with us sabreen. So endure what? Seek help with in patience and with prayers, because Allah will be with the sabreen. So what the lessons we learn? That prayer and patience plays a special role in our lives. And prayers also affects salah, namaz. Prayers also affects us. When we pray, it is shown in our behavior. And you can deal with your challenges easily. When you pray, you feel calm. You feel, you know, tranquility. When you do zikr, when you do you offer prayers, peace and, you know, Allah, bizikrillah, tatmainul khulub, verily, by the zikr of Allah, by the remembrance of Allah, by the prayers of Allah, this is an ayah, the heart find peace and tranquility by the zikr and remembrance of Allah. Okay? So how can you tell a person is patient? How we come to know? He may talk about it, but don't make it a big deal. You talk about it, you take help. Oh, such and such thing has happened to your siblings, to your parents. Now what should I do? They will help. You talk about it. But don't make it a big deal. Why me? I pray. I attend halqa. I know the Quran. This much I have learned. And I'm always thankful to God. I'm always thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I learned through verses and ayah that Allah will be with me and Allah will forgive me. And then why, you know, hardship and this test for me? Why this calamity fall on me? Don't make it a big deal. Because when a mu'min is pricked by a thorn, then also his or her, you know, ranks are elevated. You know, he gets the reward. So don't make it a big deal. So, and don't say anything negative. And sabreen, what they do, he does not complain and say, why this is happening to me? Why me? So don't make it a big deal. And, you know, my dear sisters and daughters, life is full of challenges. But if you be patient, you can tolerate those difficulties. By patience, you will be able to tolerate also. When you make a fuss out of it, make a big deal, and you know, why me? Why this is happening to me? Complaining. So you won't be able to tolerate it, you know, that difficult situation. So always think of your difficulties as temporary and think that this is a test. My ranks are elevated. My status are elevated. Allah will give me a reward. So always think of your difficulty as temporary, because you know, for the time being, it comes and it passes away. It's only a test, and it's, you know, elevating your status. So always think of your difficulties as temporary, and that they are a source of reward for you. So life is full of challenges. So you need sabr all the time. Sabr is very difficult, very difficult. I know it's very difficult. But because it's difficult, its fruit is also very beneficial. Okay? Though it is difficult, but its fruits is also beneficial. Right? So, do sabar. I hope sabar is clear to all of us. So okay, let's do tafsir and then we'll conclude inshallah. So we did this ayah. Ya ayyuhallazina amanu istainu bis-sabri was-salah inna allaha ma'as-sabirin. Oh, you believe, seek help in patience and as-salah, the prayer. Truly Allah is with as-sabirin, the patient ones. After Allah commanded that he be appreciated, he ordained patience and prayer. It is a fact that the servant is either enjoying a bounty that he should be thankful for or suffering a calamity that he should meet with patience. So always we are in two state. What are the two state? What are two state? That either enjoying a bounty, either enjoying the favor and the blessings, or so we should be thankful that, or either a servant is suffering from a calamities. So there are always two states. Okay. So there's a hadith. Amazing is the believer, for whatever Allah decrees for him, it is better for him. Okay. So believer is always amazing. Whatever Allah decrees for him, he thinks that it is better for him, whether good or bad, good fate or bad fate. It's Allah's decree. This is my fate, so it is better for me. If he is tested with a bounty, he is grateful for it, and that is better for him. And if he is afflicted with a hardship, he is patient with it, and that is better for him. In both cases, amazing is the believer, because he is always grateful. Whether he's tested with a bounty or whether he's afflicted with hardships, he is always, you know, grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that both the things are better for me. It is from Allah. So Allah loves more than my mother. Allah loves 70 times more than the mother loves. So it's better for the servant, whatever Allah decrees. So Allah has stated that the best tools to help ease the effects of the afflictions are patience and prayer. Earlier, it was mentioned that wastainu bi sabri wa salah wa innaha lakabiratun illa alal khashin. This is another ayah with reference to our ayah, and seek help in patience and as-salah, the prayer, and truly it is extremely heavy and hard except for al khashin, the true believers in Allah. Although this is very difficult, sabr, patience is very difficult in the time of hardships and calamities. This is what Allah says. Inna lakabiratun. It is extremely heavy and hard, but not for al-khashin, the true believers. It is not extremely hard for them. It is not extremely heavy or hard for them because they are true believers. They always, you know, happy that it is Allah's decree. This is Allah has made my fate. This is my destiny. So this is test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he's always contented and satisfied, and he's pleased with Allah's decree. There are several types of sabr, patience. One for avoiding the prohibitions and sins. And this is very, you know, important point. See, Allah has, you know, commanded us. There are prohibitions also, like, you know, like listening the music. People enjoy dancing and singing and, you know, listening the music. But you know that this life will end. If I am too much into music, I'm listening to music, molten wax will be poured in my ear, right? So you are avoiding, because it is prohibited. You or any other sins, like, you know. So you are avoiding yourself, you are controlling yourself. So this is also a sabr. This is also a patience, right? Avoiding the prohibitions and sins also a sabr. And this is a great thing, you know, if you are doing this, if you are, you know, away from the sins. This is also a patience. And the second one for acts of worship and obedience. You know, early morning getting up is, you know, we are in, you know, deep slumber and sleep. Nobody wants to get up from the sleep, you know, for the morning prayers. Okay. Winter is okay. You know, it's late, 6 o'clock. But summer, 4 o'clock, you know, 5 o'clock. So it becomes very, you know, hard. But not for the illa alal khashin. It is extremely heavy and hard, except for al-khashin. It is not hard. It is not extremely heavy for the true believers of Allah. Okay? So inshallah, it will not be hard for us. So Abdurrahman bin Zaid bin Asim said, we have done this. Though this was from Abdurrahman bin Asim, two types of patience, okay? No, patience for the sake of Allah concerning what he is pleased with, that is acts of worship and obedience, even if it is hard on the heart and the body. You know, this narrator is explaining the same thing. And patience when avoiding what he dislikes, even if it is desired. This is our nature. This is human nature. Satan is there. Our soul is there. Our nafs is there. You know, we are inclined, which is, to the, these things, to music and, to the things which Allah has prohibited us. But we should, control ourselves. Because a sabr is self-control. What you learn? A sabr is self-control. So those who acquire these qualities will be among the patient persons whom Allah shall greet with they meet him in the hereafter. This is referred to Surah Al-Ahzab, Allah willing. Okay, this was from the Surah Al-Ahzab. So we'll conclude here. Ayah number 153, sabr and salah are very important for iman. And when sabr is done on a difficult situation, on good deeds that it might be challenging for you, but you keep on doing it, stay firm on staying away from sins. I've explained all these points. So sabr, in other words, is self-control. It does not mean being passive, not caring, but having self-control. Okay, don't be passive, care yourself, but by side by side, have self-control, control yourself. No shouting, why me? Why is happening with me? I offer obligatory 5 prayers. I give in charity. I am obedient to parents. I avoid sins. Don't, complain. Don't make it a big deal. Your status, your rank is elevated. Allah being with them means in the general sense that Allah is with them, giving them blessings. In the specific sense that Allah provides some people specially. The person who is patient is not alone. He is not suffering in silence because Allah says, "In Allah ma'as sabreen." Indeed, verily, Allah is with those who are a sabreen. So the person who is patient is not alone. He is not suffering in silence. Allah's help is with him. Lessons. What we learn? Prayer and patience plays a special role in our lives. And when we offer salah, obligatory salah, my experience, even you must have experienced, when you are too tired of the work, for your homework, of your classes, the household work, the job you are doing, you go from home or, from workplace, you get tired when you come home. You feel not, offering salah. The moment you do wudu and you offer salah, before salah, you're feeling not doing anything. Some energy, come to you. That is called ruhani energy, like your soul become energetic, and you feel like doing more and more work. So salah affects you. When you pray, it is shown in your behavior also, because when you pray, you avoid sins also. So it is shown in your behavior also. You can deal with your challenges easily. So salah and sabr help you a lot. You can deal with your challenges also. Your hardships, your calamities, your things are asked. You can do deal it easily. So these were the lessons for us. How can you tell a person is patient? He may talk about it, but don't make it a big deal. He does not say anything negative. Why me? Why I am tested? I do this, I do. I'm very pious. He does not complain and say why this is happening to me. So life is full of challenges, but if you be patient, you can tolerate those difficulties. Always think of your difficulties as temporary, because it is time being, temporarily it comes and go. It's always a test, and test is always temporarily, and your ranks are elevated and raised, and they always think of your difficulties as temporary, and that they are a source of reward for you. Okay. You need sabr all the time. Sabr is though very difficult, but because it is difficult, its fruit is also very beneficial. Allah give you the reward for that. Okay, now I would love to take, points from you, reflections from you, inshallah. So, waakhiru da'wana, anilhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika, nashadu la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Jazakallahu khairan, may Allah reward you with goodness. Barakallah fi ilmik wa amalik wa rizqukum wa aqatukum wa ahlukum wa malukum. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. May Allah increase you in ilm, in your good deeds, in your risk sustenance, in your time, in your family, in your mal, in your everything. And may you may not be afflicted with hardships, calamities, difficult situations. But when if you are afflicted, may Allah give us patience and sabr. And today we learn through the ayah that we should seek help in difficult times and in good times also with salah and with patience. And I mentioned here one riwayah, the gist of the hadith, that whenever we see in the sunnah, in the deeds of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, whenever he was afflicted from any calamities or difficulties, he used to pray two rakah, two unit of nafil. So always don't forget, do wudu and just bow to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to, offer two unit, two rakah nafil. Okay, inshallah, you will be overcome with this affliction. May Allah not put us in difficulties. May, certain tests, we are very weak. May Allah accept your coming sitting. Now I would love to take your reflections. Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. May Allah accept what we made dua. You have done, it was a great job coming, sitting, listening, mashallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Now your reflections, inshallah, one by one. So who will be first? Fastabiqul khairat.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Yes.
Yes. These three ayats are very, very beneficial and very, very heart-touching and very important for us. Because first of all, it shows how much Allah